Well, Aussie country artist Blake Dantier, he's got a new song out, and it's one that I dare say if we had a refreshing ale, it might go more enjoyable. I'm feeling a bit tongue-tied at the moment, but we'll find out more as we chat to him about the song. G'day, Blake. How are you today?
I'm good. Are you sure you haven't had that beer already?
No, but I'm thinking about it. That's probably why I'm getting a bit tongue-tied. But anyway, we're all okay. We're here. Your new song, Wish You Were My Beer. But before we talk about that and share that with everyone, so how's things been going for you as the life of a muso, I guess, for last year and also through the Christmas festive time? How's it all been for you over the last few months?
Yeah, it's been better. You know, things started coming back towards the end of the year and gigs started to happen again. I mean, then they sort of, there was the whole Christmas thing and it all kind of went away over Christmas again, and it's just slowly starting to come back. Like I've got a gig this Friday in Sydney, and you know, hopefully it's the first of many to come. I mean, we'll see. But we went up to Tamworth just last month, me and my partner Kath, and went to the Golden Guitars and everything there, and you know, saw a couple of gigs, played a gig. So like it still happened. It was a festival on a much smaller scale than it normally is. You could drive down the main street, which is normally all sectioned off.
And
so it was, you know, it was totally different, but still a really, really great time. There was still a real vibe about, and going to the Golden Guitar Awards, that was our first time we've ever been, and that was pretty cool, you know, walking the red carpet and getting to sit down and right up close to the stage and see it all happen. There's some great performances at that night, and it's a great band. It was just a really cool experience to be a part of.
Excellent. And I understand you came back with some extra luggage too.
I forgot to mention we also went to the TSA Awards. This is the Tamworth Songwriters Association, and we picked up a couple of awards there for Best Country Ballad and New Songwriter of the Year.
And so how do you both feel about that?
Yeah, well, I think, you know, Kath is pretty excited. It was more of a, I didn't actually, I didn't know she'd entered these songs until we found out we were finalists for it, because they're all co-writes. They're her, like, you know, they're songs that she's released, but we've co-written them also, you know, because they're songwriting awards. Yep. I guess it goes to both of us, which is pretty cool. So that was a nice surprise.
Yeah, well, I thought last year the song Typical Bride, we loved it here, and I remember talking to Cass about it. She was excited, and it was a great song. So well done to the both of you, and I guess your songwriting skills, it's what you're about and what you are. So good on you for getting that award, and I'm sure it'll be the first of many, Blake.
I hope so too. It's, songwriting is where it's at for me. I think, you know, I mean, I love so many different aspects of country music, and I love playing it and I love singing it, and I really love the guitar as well, but songwriting I think is just where I just feel most at home.
So what's the process for you? Is it just about just fiddling along with the guitar, or do you hear a sound out in nature, or, you know, a phrase pops into your head, or how does it work for you? I know everyone's process is different, but what's it for you?
Yeah, everyone's process is pretty different, and I think mine has changed a lot over time, just sort of as I've developed certain skills. Like with the music side of things, I've been playing like a range of instruments for like quite some time now, so I feel like, you know, there's a chord progression that I don't know if there's a chord progression that I haven't played yet. So it's sort of like when it comes to music, you know, I'll get ideas, you know, every now and then, and they come pretty easily without me having to really try and search for ideas. It just kind of happens. But when it comes to a lyric, you know, that's the hard part for me, I guess, now, in that I have to come up with a great title first before I even start writing anything. And so, you know, I'm kind of just listening to what's happening around me and writing down things that I hear on TV or hear people say, or just wherever, like, you know, I'm always listening and just writing stuff down so that I can come back later and just see, like, oh, yeah, that could be a good title for a song. And then, you know, most of the time I've already got a musical idea that I think would be like, oh, yeah, that'll work with that. So, you know, I tend to start with the lyrics. A song doesn't happen unless I've got a title and an idea.
And that idea can obviously be anything, including beer.
Absolutely. I think too many of my songs are about beer.
So how did this whole song, Wish You Were My Beer, come about? And incidentally, how does Cass feel about this? I mean, what was her reaction?
Yeah, obviously I love Cass, but I got seriously into beer in this last year. And look, it's tough. It's tough competition between the two now. I got really heavy into home brewing. It was, just sort of something to do to pass the time in 2020.
Yep.
And I just ended up really liking it and really had a strong passion for it. I kind of set myself the goal that I wanted to be able to make my own beer that I could sell.
Yep.
And I think at the time that I made that goal, I underestimated how much effort would go into reaching that level of beer making. So, I ended up buying all the gear and, like a massive pot and a gas burner and making this stuff from scratch, throwing all the raw ingredients in. And then, I'm looking at investing into CO2 and kegs and stuff. And it's taken me much further than I thought it would. But it did get me thinking about beer a lot. And it got me sort of in the right frame of mind, I think, to tweak this song, because I had this song written at the start of the year. And then once I started getting back into beer a lot, I started also tweaking this song a lot and kind of adding to it. And, it was sort of when my beer making was at its peak that I sort of recorded this song in August last year.
Wow. And so with the home brew, what were you sort of brewing? Was it, pilsners? Was it stouts? Was it porters? What was your favorite?
I really tried to hone in on the pale ale.
Okay.
I'd made like a few different things in the past, but then there's this thing going on in beer at the moment where there's a lot of like really big, hoppy, fruity pale ales. And I thought I kind of want to make my version of that. And it's a pretty standard beer, so it seemed like a good place to sort of start learning the ropes in beer making. So I think I've made about 5 different pale ales, and I'm getting really sick of pale ales.
I had a friend too, as we sort of sidetrack here into beer, and he thought he wanted to do some stouts, and he got his sugar levels a bit wrong, and woke up one morning with all these little explosions happening in his house, and let's just say his wife saw the mess and just said, "It's your problem," and went back to bed, and he was there at 2 o'clock in the morning, cleaning up a lot. So just be careful if you're doing the stouts. I'll just pass that on.
I have heard a few horror stories like that. It hasn't happened to me yet, the exploding bottles, but I figure it must be a matter of time, right? It seems to have happened to everybody else.
Yes, it just, I hope it doesn't, but just be pre-warned. Anyway, back to the song. Now, there was something I want to ask you about the song, and it's because it gave me a sense of some of the sort of the country songs that I love from the mid-70s, especially around the 2:30 mark when you totally changed things up and got this lovely little feel coming through. Was that all part of the song, or how did that happen? Because I absolutely love that bit.
Oh, the halftime bit?
Yeah.
That's, that was one of the tweaks that I kind of put in. I think I just had a lot of time to sit on this song because I, had so much downtime and I knew that I wanted to record this one, but I just thought it could be better, right?
And it
is that 70s kind of vibe that I was thinking, because, I kick into that section with a harmonized guitar solo, which is something, that you really only got in, a bit of like prog rock or, maybe later on down the track, some British metal or some glam metal, stuff like that.
Yep.
I kind of wanted that harmonized solo to throw back to that 70s kind of rock era. And then just hearing that halftime thing, it just seemed to fit with that sort of vibe. And that's definitely what I was trying to go with this song. The sound that I'm trying to cultivate is somewhere between the 70s and the 90s in terms of sort of the traditional country and the outlaw country that was coming out of those times. And I just don't think we get enough of that these days. So, I kind of wanted to do a bit of a throwback to that.
Well, I certainly enjoyed the throwback, and it is. And when the folks get to hear the song shortly, they'll know. As soon as they hear it, they'll know, and I think they'll absolutely love it and enjoy it as well. And if they're enjoying it with one of their favorite refreshing ales, it'll be even better, but that's another story.
Now, oh, yeah, that's definitely the way to enhance it.
So, Blake, what's happening? You've got this song out. What's going on for you for the rest of 2021? I know you want to be getting out there gigging and doing things like that. Are you doing more co-writes? You got an album coming. What's happening?
Yeah, it is all kind of happening. I think it's going to be a... I mean, I said this about 2020, that it's going to be a big year. You know, look, I got plans for it to be a big year this year. There is more co-writing happening. All the stuff that I put out previously has been, like, I've been the sole writer on it, which is cool because, you know, I think I can be a little bit anal about the details. So, you know, that's worked for me so far. But, you know, I'm enjoying starting to co-write with other people and get what other people can sort of bring to the table in terms of the songs. And we've got the whole album tracked now. So we just finished tracking this week, actually.
Yep.
And there's about 11 songs. And, man, I can't wait to get them out there on an album. I think that'll be happening sometime in the back half of the year. Until then, there's a couple more singles to come. There's a lot going on.
Are they co-written with Cass by any chance or with other people?
I think they're still just sole co-writes. Okay. Sole writes by myself. Yep. Yeah, so we might have to wait until album number two to start seeing some of these co-writes come through.
And which do you prefer? Do you prefer co-writing or being on your own? Or are they two different experiences that you enjoy that it's hard to compare them?
Yeah, I think they are pretty different because I like to work kind of slowly, I think, on the song. And it takes me a little while to think of something. But when you're in a room with other people, it's sort of there's a little bit of pressure to sort of come up with the idea quickly. But the idea does happen quicker because there's more people there. So it's... They're sort of different. You get a different type of song, I think, when I'm doing a co-write as opposed to when I'm writing it on my own. But, you know, that being said, a lot of the stuff that we've been putting together for Cal Sutton's album is mostly co-written. So, you know, I think we get some really cool songs out of that, and I'm really looking forward to that coming out as well.
All right, so it's going to be a big year for the pair of you. Well, good to hear.
Oh, yeah.
All right, so we're going to have to wait to the back half of this year for your album, but we do have a couple of tracks in the meantime that we'll get to enjoy. So I'm looking forward to hearing the whole album. That's going to be, I think, a highlight from 2021. So just quietly.
I think there's going to be a lot of releases this year, so it could be a bit of competition.
Yeah, well, let's think, as a listener and a fan of music, then I'm more than let that happen.
Yeah, absolutely.
Yes, it's more to share around. I certainly enjoy it. Well, Blake, it has been absolutely fabulous chatting to you again. I really look forward to it, and we'll have to do it over a beer at some stage. We've got to make that happen. But we've got your song here, and I just want quickly, before we get to hear it, you didn't do a video for it. Why wasn't there a video of you sort of, you know, making beer or something? And there should have been.
There is a video in the works. Yeah, we've already shot it, but we're still in editing, so sort of waiting for it to be done. But we went for something very unique, I would say, with this music video. I didn't want to go for something that was so closely related to the actual subject matter of the song, really, just because I feel like the song conjures up that imagery itself.
Yep.
And what I wanted to do was something just a little bit zany. So this music video is set on a retro game show called Wish You Were My Beer.
Oh.
And, I mean, that's pretty much all you need to know about it. It'll probably be out in a couple of weeks.
All right. Well, I'll be looking forward to that. And let us know when it's out, because I will let all the Flow listeners know. But in the meantime, we do have the song here ready to enjoy, and especially take note of that 2:30 moment, folks. But you're going to enjoy this song. Blake, thank you so much for spending time with us today. It's been an absolute pleasure. Good luck with everything, and say good day to Cass for us as well. We've got your song here ready to go. If you could please introduce it for all the Flow listeners.
No worries. I'm Blake Dantier, and this is my brand new single, Wish You Were My Beer, on Flow FM.
They ought to give me the front door key. I'm more than a regular now. Been trying to get over you under the schooners ain't doing what they should by now. I should be is blue. I've gone from ale to pilsner, sour to stout, and they all remind me of you. Every sip is like your lips on mine. With each hit I'm traveling back in time. We were good together in those days. Now they're just a dream in amber haze. I don't know what's gonna bring you back. So I keep building up this empty stack. And it's made one thing clear. I wish you were my bear. I've tried everything they've got on tap, and they all have the same effect. If there's one thing in here that don't bring back your memory, honey, I ain't found any yet. 'Cause every sip is like your lips on mine. With each hit I'm traveling back in time. We were good together in those days. Now they're just a dream in amber haze. I don't know what's gonna bring you back. So I keep building up this empty stack. And it's made one thing clear. I wish you were my beer. It's like our whole past is right there in that glass. And I don't ever want to put it down. Stop. Every sip is like your lips on mine. With each hit I'm traveling back in time. We were good together in those days. Now they're just a dream in amber haze. I don't know what's gonna bring you back. So I keep building up this empty stack. And it's made one thing clear. I'd rather you were here. I wish you were my baby.